Next topic. I want to get into this Vince McMahon stuff. If you guys don't know, Vince McMahon, is or was is the owner of the WWE. This is him here in the hospital. But right now, he is not in the hospital. In fact, I don't think he's sick at all, at least not health-wise, because he's facing a few allegations from a woman named Janelle Grant, right? He's being accused of sexual assault. And it's right here, says that his sexual assault accuser speaks out. All right, let's check this out. The former WWE employee who allegedly was sexually abused by Vince McMahon broke her silence Friday, saying she hopes any doors of secrecy have been blown off their hinges. Janelle Grant claimed the wrestling mogul coerced her into having sex with wrestling stars and other WWE executives, along with more lurid allegations that including McMahon defecating on her head during a threesome and using sex toys on her that he named after wrestlers, according to the lawsuit filed Thursday. Wow. Defecating on her head. Okay. Now remember I said some of this now, if some of this is true, this is making P. Diddy seem like an angel. Right? This is making P. Diddy seem like not as bad. She hopes those at the company, past and present, who fear speaking out about harm is a thing of the past, Grant said in a statement read by her St. Louis-based attorney, Ann Callis. She wishes them all peace. Callis relayed the statement during an interview she gave to Law & Crime podcast Crime Fix with Angie Levy. A spokesperson for McMahon said the lawsuit was riddled with falsehoods, baseless fabrications of events that never transpired, and a malicious distortion of the truth. Okay, so a spokesperson for Vince McMahon is basically saying that this is not true. Of course, what they all say. This is Janelle Grant right here. She's pretty. This is a beautiful lady. Of course, allegedly, this is the accuser. This is the lady who is saying that Vince McMahon sexually abused her. Mr. McMahon intends to vigorously defend himself against these allegations, the spokesperson said. Let's see. McMahon is also alleged to have shared new photos and explicit videos of Grant without her consent with other WWE employees, according to the lawsuit. He once locked her inside his private locker room at WWE headquarters in Stamford and forced himself on her over a massage table, the complaint said. Wow. WWE boss is also alleged to have directed Grant to have sex with other executives and a wrestling star, the lawsuit claims. John Laurinaitis, WWE's former head of talent relations, who was named as a defendant in the lawsuit, was allegedly recruited by McMahon to have sex with Grant. Grant was told by McMahon to visit Laurinaitis in his hotel rooms where she had sex with him before work days. It was alleged in the lawsuit. In one encounter at WWE offices in June 2021, McMahon and Laurinaitis forced themselves on her and took turns restraining her for the other. It was alleged in the lawsuit. No means yes, and take it. B were among the things McMahon and Laurinaitis said to Grant during the alleged assault, according to the lawsuit. In July 2021, McMahon told Grant to create sexualized content on her phone and send it to Brock Lesnar, a former UFC star whom the WWE was trying to sign at the time. All right, so they got Brock Lesnar caught up in this. Now, I think we know Brock Lesnar. This is Brock Lesnar. Where were we? Last July, federal law enforcement agents executed a search warrant and served a federal grand jury subpoena to McMahon, according to a regulatory filing. WWE said in the filing with the Securities and Exchange Commission that while government investigations into McMahon remain ongoing, no charges have been brought against them. So no charges have been brought against them? Okay. All right. So McMahon is facing sexual allegations. And just 4 hours ago, it shows that the WWE founder, Vince McMahon, has resigned after being hit with a sexual assault lawsuit. So Vince McMahon has resigned, people. It is the end of an era. Shout out to Vince McMahon. That's a blow to a lot of us who grew up watching wrestling. Right? A lot of us grew up watching wrestling. And we're fans of a lot of the stars, the superstars of arm wrestling, not only of them, but of Vince McMahon and his family themselves. But we didn't know that a lot of this was going on, right? We didn't know that allegedly some of this stuff was going on behind the scenes. Now, these are some of the text messages right here. Remembering the lawsuit, it spoke on text messages and a few other things. These are some of the text messages that were sent. Let's read these. Okay, look, it says, following the threesome on May 11, 2020, McMahon sent an explicit message to Mrs. Grant that further detailed his fantasies of seeing her engaged in sexual relations. Okay, so these are officially in the suit. These were given to the court. These were given to authorities. These are officially documented in a suit. This is said to be Vince McMahon. Okay, it says, can you guys see this? It says, I love it. That's you, Janelle, right? Remember, this is Janelle Grant. This is Janelle Grant. Okay, it says, I love it. That's you, Janelle. You just can't get enough, can you? In the future, it's going to be so bad that you'll demand to be fucked twice a day and not just with in a three-way. I can't see what that says. Why not let others see the beautiful, voluptuous body and watch you shake uncontrollably when you come? Now, chat, what's Vince McMahon on? Is this real? This is in the paperwork now. They'll go out of their minds. Then I'll find more friends and we'll tie you up so you're helpless. What? I'll direct them to have their way any way they want. Who can make you scream the loudest? Maybe I'll just line them up and have them scream. It was the CEO of WWE, the CEO of WWF, out here sending text messages like this. Maybe I'll just line them up and have them squirt in your mouth, your pussy, and all over your tits and ass all at the same time. You'll be covered in cum and we'll make you eat it all and taste everybody's. Yo, can I even say this? I don't even know if I can even read this on chat, man. I don't want this to get me banned. I'm going to try to skip over some of these words. What is going on, man? What are these guys talking about? You'll be covered in, and we'll make you eat it all and taste everybody's. The next morning, you will be a little sore, but you're still going to want more. After all that, over and over. Okay, let's see. This looks like a new text message. After the threesomes began, McMahon became more sadistic in his fantasies focused on control, such as choking, sensory deprivation, pain, humiliation, and group scenarios in which Mrs. Grant was to be physically overwhelmed and subservient. Wow. Read your last picture. What does that mean? You need your panties ripped off. and three big black dicks in the pause. Pause, man. And three big black dicks in all three holes at the same time. Yo, why does it always gotta be, yo, why does it seem like when white guys, we've seen this before, right? We've seen this before. When white guys, when they talk like this, right? When they get super angry and they talk like this to their women, why does it always gotta be black dicks? I think Mel Gibson said something like that. Let's pull this up, man. We're calling these guys out, man. Why does it always gotta be three big black dicks? Right? Okay, shout out to us. Right? We like that. We'll take that as a compliment. Shout out to us. We know that we... Pause for what I'm saying right now. But we know that we packing, right? We know that we're hung. We know that we're generally more hung than white guys, right? Or Hispanics or other races, whatever you want to call it, whatever you want to say, right? But we're calling this out right now, man, because why do I always have to be that? Why do we always have to get thrown under the bus? Wait, I'm afraid, Mel Gibson, I'm gonna put Mel Gibson rant. I'm afraid to put that. I don't want anything crazy to pop up. Look, he told his wife, look, this is when Mel Gibson went on the rant. He told his wife she'd be R-word by a pack of N's, right? This is what Mel Gibson said in his rant. Why does all have to be that, man? Why do we have to get thrown under the bus? You need your panties ripped off and three big black dicks in all three holes at the same time. Pause, man. Pause. Vince McMahon, if this is true, man, you're going down, you scumbag. Just for that alone. Just for that alone, you're going down, you scumbag. We trusted you, we loved you, we watched you, we supported you, Vince McMahon. But this shit here is wrong. Alright? And you throwing us under the bus. But you compliment us at the same time. We thank you for that. Right? But this is wrong, man. Stop using us. You guys need to stop using us. When you're degrading women, when you're angry at your women, stop using us. Stop using us to cause violence. Stop using us to speak harm. Stop using us to wish ill on anyone. Right? Weigh up your as far as they will go, but even farther. Come on, man. And the thickest goes down your throat so it makes you gag and come up. Yo, man. What? Should I even read this? You gag and convulse as those big black cocks pound away. Pause. Pause, man. Why are you guys so obsessed with what we have? Vince McMahon, I don't even know if I want to read this. Guys, if you want to, you guys can read this. This is here. This is sick, man. This is straight sick. As you lay on your stomach, this is sick, man. Why is he so angry? As the threesomes began, McMahon became more sadistic and his fantasies focused on control. Yo, man, why are we not talking about this, man? We blew Diddy out of the water. We blew Diddy up, right? You guys reading this? Now look, this says, okay, around this time, McMahon openly shared explicit photographs and, what is this, this is kind of small. This salacious, I can't read this, salacious stories about Mrs. Graham with the WWE crew at TV tapings, a group McMahon also referred to as her fan club. So they're saying McMahon, that he showed people photographs, explicit photographs of, and salacious stories, what was that? Y'all heard that? What was that? I think it was a door. Hold on one second. I gotta check. I don't like that. I think that was the win, hopefully. I don't know what that was, but don't worry. Yeah, we're good. Okay, let's get back to this. So he shared photos of her with a crew of TV tapings, and he called them, referred to the group as her fan club. Indeed, McMahon exuberantly messaged her a truthful story of having just shared explicit content of her with a group of 12 men on the WWE tech crew and recounted the obscene details he shared with them. Okay, so it was a truthful story. So he said it was a truthful story in quotations. And he recounted the obscene details he shared with them. So this is him texting what he shared with them. Can I make this any bigger? I don't know if I can read this. Let me see if I can pull this up on the phone. No, we're going to get into this because we got to cover everything, right? This is Vince McMahon, the CEO of the WWE, right? To me, this is just as crazy, if not crazier than P. Diddy, right? But a lot of times, these guys go untalked about, they go unnoticed, they go swept under the rug, and these victims never get justice, right? Because while we do, when I say we, I would say the black community, we tend to attack our own, right? We tend to attack our own, blow up big on our own, which the wrongdoings that our own do, that anybody does, need to be attacked and brought to light, right? But we tend to do that on our own or to our own, but when stories like this come out of other people that we have even enjoyed, that we have invested our time, even some of our money into, we tend to turn our heads, right? So we need to break this down. All right. Let me see if I can find this, because we got to read this. There was some interesting stuff in this right here, too. Let's see. It's too small for me to read it on the screen, so I want to see if I can read it from my phone. Let's see if I can find this. Chat, give me 1 second. Let's see if I can find this. Where is it? Hold on. Okay, here we go. Okay, I have it. Okay, all right, I have it. Okay, so it just says, I don't know if you guys can see it on the screen, but I'm going to read some of it. Let's see. It says, I just passed my phone around to a bunch of guys on the tech crew. This is what this is saying in the paperwork. This is what Vince McMahon texted. This is the text that he sent to Mrs. Janelle Grant, right? It says, I just passed my phone around to a bunch of guys on the tech crew. They were screaming, OMG, she's fucking beautiful. Look at that ass. I'd like to get that. I paused to count out loud how many guys there were. 12. And then I said, okay, there's 12 of you, and she would love to fuck each and every one of you at one time. So he's basically telling them that you guys can have her. She would love to fuck all 12 of you, right? The guys cheered. But she will only do it if she takes 3 at a time. That brought a huge reaction. She wants one deep in her, one way down her throat, and one in her pee. And you can pound her and keep on pounding her till you pop your... She may scream and try to say no, although it would be difficult to say anything with a down her throat. This is wrong, man. This is so wrong. This is even sick to even read. I don't even feel comfortable reading this. Let's go to the second page. Baby, these guys were having a blast with me. Some of them didn't believe me, so I said, you were the greatest F in the world, and no matter how much you get, you always wanted more. And then I said, she loves C. Baby, these techs, as we call them, were having the time of their lives listening to my truthful story. I then said, you would take a 10-minute break between each, but then you would get back on your hands and knees with your... Man, this is wrong. I drove them wild, baby. Or I should say, you drove them wild. Just imagine if this really happened, baby. How much C you would... No. Okay, and then it goes to the next page. On February 5th, 2021, McMahon sent Mrs. Grant to establish a schedule for when other men, including physical therapists and Laurinaitis, could have sex with Mrs. Grant, which Mrs. Grant attempted to rebuff. Exactly, baby. He's not the only one. Blank called me this afternoon begging to eat you and with his knife. Oh, man. Give me another week, baby, and I'll be ready. I'm feeling more like myself. It's not great, but it's getting better. Tell him soon. I already told him, baby. By the way, so apparently this is her. Leslie, this is her texting him back. Right? Says, give me another week, baby, and I'll be ready. I'm feeling more like myself. It's not great, but it's getting better. Tell him soon. And this doesn't mean that that she wanted this, right? It says that she attempted to rebuff this, right? I would guess that she attempted to rebuff this because she didn't want people to take this text message, take her text, and then say, okay, there's a text that says, give me a week, I'll be ready. She wanted this, right? This doesn't mean that she wanted this. It still could be what she's alleging to have happened. Looks like he has her doing this. We just read text of him saying he's shown people that this is going to happen, that she wants all 12. He says, I already told him, baby. By the way, Johnny wants Tuesdays, but not this coming one. Johnny who? Johnny? Who's Johnny? Is Johnny a tech or a wrestler? But not this coming one. And the occasional Saturday. But maybe I can shift it to Thursday nights. To Thursday nights? Johnny would like all the above. Wow, man. This... You know, if this is true, then Vince McMahon is a monster, man. Remember they mentioned Brock Lesnar? They mentioned Brock Lesnar, chat. We know Brock Lesnar is married. Brock Lesnar, like, I want no parts of this. Now, this is crazy because this is the business man I know, man. This is the business man I know right here. This businessman that we've all known, look, this is 1998. He's in a hospital here.
Every time you've taken it, you've found that it's normal. Every single time.
Yes, Mr. McMahon, it'll be all right. We're almost done.
I can't wait to get out of here.
Okay, so this is businessman in the hospital. And, I'm not sure. He hurt his ankle. He hurt his ankle. And this is Mankind.
Damn it, leave.
A lot of us know Mankind. A lot of us watch this, man. This is Mankind visiting him in the hospital.
Take this crap with you.
Vince, can you hear?
He hurt his ankle. Take this, right?
Last time it was normal. You're going to find it's normal this time.
So he's trying to get out of the hospital.
Every time you've taken it, you've found that it's normal. Every single time.
Looks just fine to me. How about you, doctor?
Oh, I'll take it from here, nurse.
No, no! 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 No,
Oh, that's Stone Cold. I thought that was a nurse. This man thought it was a nurse too. That was a nurse too. Why are they beating up on Vince, man? This is Stone Cold.
It's just fine to me. How about you, doctor?
Oh, I'll take it from here, nurse.
Look at Vince's face. Look at Vince's face. When you heard his voice, look at his face. He said, I know that voice.
Here, nurse.
Yo, chat, this is back when wrestling was lit, man. This is back when wrestling was lit, man. WWE Raw. I don't know, man. Maybe he deserved this, man. If all this is coming out to be true, maybe he deserved his beatdown. Alright? This is Stone Cold. This is the Vince McMahon that we all knew. But apparently, there was a whole other side to Vince McMahon. Right? Apparently, this woman is saying that Vince McMahon was a monster. Or that Vince McMahon is a monster. And if that's true, if some of these text messages are true, I hope he faces justice, man. I hope he faces the consequences of his actions. Right? Because what we've read, the stuff we've seen, the stuff he's been accused of, is completely sick. Right? This is Ken Shamrock on Vince McMahon Hush Money scandal. I want to see what this was. And it was no secret in the WWE. All right, let's see when this was. This was January 2026. Let's see.
Well, we fast forward to 2022, this year. Vince McMahon was always such a huge figure in WWE and WWF before then. But then in April of 2022, an investigation started, where they found that there's $3 million in hush money that he paid over affairs with former employees of the company. There was also other, you know, agreements that he paid off various people that totaled like $12 million. But from your point of view, what did you
think? It hasn't been a secret. I mean, like, there's always been allegations, and I don't think anybody really truly believes they weren't true. I think they just believe that they, like you, we know now, they were just paid off for, you know, hush money. So this is no shock. I mean, like, we live in this world, and it happens all the time.
Okay, so he's saying that this man has been on his P. Diddy box, right? Saying he's paid off, hush money, right? That's why a lot of this stuff hasn't came out. But apparently what Mrs. Janelle Grant has came out, right? Apparently these text messages has came out, right? Like I said, if these are in the paperwork, if this is in fact true, then I think Vince McMahon has resigned. Look, where there's smoke, there's fire. It's like I said, this is a guy that we grew up watching, his organization, the stuff that he put together. Where there's smoke, there's fire, right? Some of these guys you think you know, some of these people you enjoy, but you never know what they do or what they have going on behind the scenes, You know, you never know what they do behind the scenes, right? We see how they treat people, how they may treat people on TV where we see them, or in media or in public where we see them, but we always don't know how they treat people behind the scenes, and how they treat certain people, right? And it's because they treat one person one way, don't mean that they may treat another person that way. And it looks like he's been treating this woman, Janelle Grant, very wrong, right? If this isn't in fact true, I hope that he faces the consequences, the just and due consequences, right? And if this is not true, then I hope she faces the consequences for accusing of someone of these things. But from what we see from the evidence that's listed from Vince McMahon's move, this is not the move of someone who's innocent. Doesn't resign. This isn't the first time he's been accused of this. We just saw Ken Shamrock speak on Hush Money. I don't know. Let us see how this plays out. We'll see if his Hush Money, maybe he has enough Hush Money to pay her off. And it looks like it's just a lawsuit right now. It doesn't look like he's facing charges. It looks like it's just a lawsuit. So it looks like it's just about money right now, right? Looks like it doesn't look like he will be going into jail. It doesn't look like he's facing any criminal charges. So it looks like it's just about money right now. But I wish the best for all parties involved, especially for any victims involved. But we'll see where this goes. All right. Let's move on to...